We have a very, very, very special treat. This woman has been doing stand-up comedy since 1983. She's been on television shows. She's opened for Jerry Seinfeld. She's a national touring comedian. And she is, honest to God, she said, don't call her a legend, but I am going to call her a Portland treasure. It is Susan Rice, and I'm so excited. You guys are in for such a treat.
I could reach out. Oh my God! Why aren't you doing something here? Well, Mark's here. Hi, how are you? Come on in. So this is. Did you have a hard time finding this place? Yeah. You know, it pisses me off. I get out at night. I'm looking. It's hard to see this place. Come on, honestly. If you don't know where the hell you're going, and that bitch on my phone, she doesn't know shit. I end up at somebody's house. Oh, really? Well, I guess this is a big secret. You know? Keep it like a secret, but carry a gun. Anyway, I come across the street and I said to this gal, she's very nice, I'm sure she's here. But I've asked two other people before I asked her, I go, hey, do you know where the Jackpot studios are? And they look at me like, are you lost? That depends. Do you know how to answer a fucking question? Anyway, I'm gonna fluff my hair so my ass looks smaller. don't get tired. You know, she's so sweet, isn't she cute? I had treasure. Yeah, well, this treasure last night was at the Moose Lodge in Chehalis, so let's keep it all in perspective here. If I'd known I could have Skyped this motherfucker, I would have been on my lazy boy. Are you kidding me? That is a great deal. Fuck, I can work forever now. She should have ended it with a flush, though. Come on, really? That would have been perfect for her to go, all right, good night, katoosh. Because doesn't that make you crazy when you know you're talking to somebody on the phone? And we never talk on the phone when we're on the toilet, do we? Did you have to flush? Really, I could have just lived with the image of you not on the toilet, but now I have it. So anyway, so who won? Did you win something, raffles?
I did.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, good. Look at that. That's completely fucking worthless. And that's that's the kind of raffle shit you want to take to work. Drop it on your secret Santa's desk. My secret Santa this year was a fucking tea bagger. It was. And I don't know where to return the stuff. You know, where do you take back a book that says God and guns? Way to salvation. Okay, that should have done better here. That really should have done better. Really, you guys have let me down. Yeah, the tea bagger. Oh, that's right, we're in Southeast. Thank God we're not on the Hawthorne. I'm not allowed on Hawthorne after 9 o'clock at night unless I have a dog and a bike. You guys are going, she's kind of judgmental, isn't she? That's right. So did you get the holidays? Is it all down now at everybody's house? Did you put some stuff up at the holiday for the holidays? Mm-hmm. A little bit. Nothing big. Yeah. Awesome. Did you? Did you decorate at all? You did? Yeah. Did you put stuff out in the yard?
Yeah, actually.
Did you? You decorate. The people across the street have not taken their shit down yet. And they went to Fred Meyer and bought everything they could possibly buy that could go in their yard, which is also much smaller than this space. It was just ridiculous. It's still, they bought the blow-up Santa, the blow-up penguin. They got the deer going up and down like that. They got the baby Jesus and the Mary and the Joseph and the ass and the donkeys and all kinds of shit. And they got the angel, you know, and a good wind. It looks like a damn orgy over there. Something's getting goosed by the deer, you know. Santa's going down on Mary. The angel's surprised. I've given away all the candy. People gave me candy. Here, we'd like you to die. Thank you. So I've given that all up, and I got everything. I started my year out with a little. Did you make resolutions anymore? People don't just, you know. Here's something I did today too that I don't recommend. When you're lonely and maybe just a little depressed, do not clean out a closet and start going through old notebooks. Because I read all these, you know, affirmations. I'm beautiful. I'm lovely. I attract wonderful men. Bullshit. It's all just shit. I'm not married. I don't have kids either that I know of. And, the 80s are a little hazy. I didn't always look like Aunt B, goddammit. About a 2 months period, I was about a size 10. I could have been a Spice Girl, you know. Tell me what you want, like I really, really care. Anyway, they were a singing group in the late 80s. Okay. You're very young.
Really?
Started out the year. I'm trying to be healthy now. I have these new glasses. I keep looking. I can't. Can you see them? Jesus Christ! You can see them from space. This is what happens when they dilate an old gal's eyes, and then they go, "Hey, why don't you go pick out some frames?" I picked these bad boys up. I went, oh my God. Yeah, I'm going to look surprised for the next 5 years. And they're like multifocals, you know, one for each personality. And, I've been on this quest, you know, because everything's falling apart on me now. I'm kind of excited. I might have to sit down, but I don't think I'll have to. 60 fucking three. If I want to sit down, I'm gonna sit down. She came out of the room on that one. Do you need to sit down? I've been recovering the last year and a half. I got hit by a car in front of Powell's bookstore in a crosswalk. Yeah, on a sunny morning, a beautiful morning, crossing from 10th over towards Powell's, and I had the light, and I'm crossing, and some guy turned left from 10th on, and he hit me. He hit me, and I got back up. You know, because weevils wobble. And he hit me again. I stayed down that time. This fucker knows me. You know, you're late. It's the weirdest thing because you've thought in your mind, because we've all almost hit somebody on Burnside right in there. It's just people crossing hilly nilly, not caring, and you have this mind. Getting hit on Burnside. Well, there I am laying on Burnside down. I'm thinking I can suck it up under this Dodge Dart if this guy wants to go for me one more time. You know. And then, but what happened was then just so surreal. He rolled the. He didn't get out of the car. He just hit this old fuzzy-haired short woman, you know, and who's who he hasn't seen now for a few seconds. And he doesn't get out of the car. He rolled the window down. You know, and when I saw that action, I thought, not a lot of insurance involved here. He rolled the window down, and he leaned out, and he goes, oh, geez, I didn't see ya. Well, evidently, I am invisible, so we have dated. And It's stupid, you know. So then what happens with this, and everybody keep healthy, you young, beautiful people, it happens to you. It catches up. One little thing happens, then it's the next damn thing, and then it's the next damn thing. You know, after that, I got to wear the support hose. Those are attractive. Those are lovely. Yeah, that makes you feel really feminine. And then I got the sleep apnea. Yeah, that's attractive. Come on, Daddy. Come on, Daddy. Come on. You want a little of this? Don't pull the hose. Don't pull the hose. Not a real guy. Don't pull the hose. I went to bed. They had me hooked up the other night to a heart monitor, which meant I had all this bullshit on me up here. And then I put that on, and I looked in the mirror and went, I need a gun. I need to put myself out of my fucking misery. Look at this bullshit. Come on, Daddy. I was like a cross between the Unabomber and, you know, and Hannibal Lecter. Come here. Rob a bank in my nightgown. Okay, now I'm just entertaining myself. I don't care about anybody. So then I'm dieting. Can you tell? Can you tell? Mark knows me. Yeah, you better say yes. You're right. You're with it. Slapping. I bikini season's coming right up. That's what I'm shooting for. I've lost my family. You gotta lose weight, too. You don't lose weight now. You're not gonna be around for our kids. And I'm thinking I didn't like you. So I'm not good at groups. They signed me up for that Weight Watchers thing, and I thought it sounded like a good program, Weight Watchers, you know, because somebody keep an eye on this shit, because I'm busy. And that's not how it works, really. And of course, I've gotten kicked out of that one. I got asked to move out of that group, because evidently I'm disruptive. Question authority immediately. you know, it's difficult. The holidays are difficult. I'm reading everything I can now. Do you read the labels? You read the labels. You look very. Everybody reads the labels. You got to read the labels. You know, and it takes hours with these bad boys. So I'm glutton free now, and I hate going to the grocery store anyway. I hate it. It's just, now it just takes too long because you have to read everything. And, you know, we're from Oregon, so we have to be GMO, this bullshit, and then you gotta have that, and you can't have so much of this, and what's a gram, and I used to know. In Safeway, I have to shop at the Safeway in my neighborhood because that's where all the old people go. And... Because Trader Joe's, if you don't bring a bag, they spank you. God, what a bunch of fucking bag Nazis. Honest to God. I forgot a bag and then went, oh, well. You know, just buying $2 Chuck, I can take it out without a bag. I don't care. So, I hate that store. I hate going to the stores where they sneak up on you. Do you have that experience? People bothering you? You know, they just, hi, how are you? I'm fine. Oh, shit, I'm fine. Leave me up. Why? Wait, what have you heard? Wait, come here. You know. And you're in the store and you see somebody like me. Like, you know, don't interrupt me. I'm standing there. I've forgotten my list and I can't remember what the hell's on it, and I can't get past cat food. Yeah, there's a surprise, huh? I have a cat. I don't have a man, I have a cat. It's the same thing at my age. It really is. You talk to the cat ignores you. then he jumps on you at night. And I'm always, you know, don't interrupt me. I mean, and they mean well. You know, they're always, hi, you find everything? Shit, I gotta start over now. Yeah, I'm fine. Just leave me alone. Get to the end of the aisle. There she is again. Hi, are you finding everything? You need shit to do, don't you? Okay. I need an early pregnancy test, and I need it now. I'm not good at it, and I get lost in the aisles now. You should be able to get two carts up an aisle at the same time. You used to be able to do that without taking out a mother of four. You know, just, bitch, I'm not backing up, look at me. Put one of those kids in the damn basket, because I'm not, you know, there's no room. And then, in the cart that looks like a little car. Oh, who invented that? You put the little ADD bastards in there. And then you drag them by shit they can't have. Until they work themselves into such a frenzy. The minute those kids see me, they're on me, you know.
You're fatty.
Did you say that to me? No, you shouldn't say that to me. That's not nice. No, there's no Santa. Now, we're both living with disappointment, aren't we? With kids, really. I try to be. Kids love me for some reason. They think I'm going to be soft. Yeah, oh, good. Whatever that was, that's cute. Halloween's a challenge, really, you know. Because I gave out Halloween candy for the first time this year. And I realized, because I'm always on the road, this year I was actually home for Halloween. It was so weird. And I bought you buy the candy? Did you buy Halloween candy? Yeah. Do you buy the day before? Yeah, you buy the day. So you buy shit you're not going to eat? Yeah. You know, that doesn't really exist. You know, I'll get out of bed at 3 for a dot. Do you understand? It calls to me. I'll lose a crown for that bad boy. You know? But I gave out Halloween candy for the first time, and I realized I'm really not a giver. I'm really more of a slapper. two, you greedy little bastard, two. Wait a minute, what's in your bag? I'm running low. Come here. Don't cry, your dad's halfway down the block. The old kids scared me this year. Have you had old? They scare you. Why did... Mark, how old were you the last time you went? How old were you the last time you went Halloween trick or treat?
32.
You're a sick fuck. I walked into that one, didn't I? I don't know. I don't remember that. I remember how old, you know, this kid came to. How old are you? 17. Well, come on in. Bet you that ninja suit is hot, huh? Oh, that's crazy. They gotta be 18.
Yeah.
I am not going to jail for a turtle. I really shouldn't be out in public, pretty much. No, really. I really used to think I was nice. I'm not. I'm in the grocery store the other day, and I just hate the grocery store anymore. I'm always in back of the stinky guy. And I'm not talking about people that are homeless. I would never judge their life. Their life is much harder than mine, and I would never judge them. And I would never stand in back of them either. But I'm just telling you. I'm talking about somebody who's normal. This guy right over here. Look at how normal you look. Except for the 1970s chops. But anyway. Yeah. Sure, you're... girlfriend loves it. It's like a loofah. Anyway. you look like you bathed in the last 48 hours at least, right? Yeah, you got clean clothes on. That hoodie is old but clean. Yeah. And, I'm talking about people that put on clean clothes, but they don't bathe for 3 months. You know, that kind where you kind of, oh, you get up on them, but you can't move now because there's another guy in back of you. Oh, shit, I can't. And I'm just tearing up. I'm tearing up, and he's standing there, and he's this young kid. He looks okay, but he's got clean clothes on. He's got the hockey pucks embedded in his earlobes. Okay, this is bullshit. I'm sorry, and I'm in the wrong area of town to start talking about this, but I'm telling you right now, this is bullshit. That hockey puck thing is crazy. You know, you don't have... these people don't have grandparents. Because you go and look at an old person's ears, they don't stop growing. By the time those holes get to 55 years old, they're a damn jungle gym for the grandkids. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna have to tuck them into your shirt and shit. It's just ridiculous. You can't pull that off at your kid's graduation. Dad's gotta sit out of the wind, otherwise he'll take off. You know, this kind of shit. And then this is one whole week this all happened. Then I'm in line the other day and there's a guy talking on the phone. I don't want to hear conversations in line. I think all of us actually would rather not hear specific conversations. And we understand if you're standing in line and you're checking in with your family, you go, okay, I'll be home in a minute, blah, 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 this is that. That's one thing. I'm standing there, this guy's talking nasty to some girl. I mean, just, hey, baby, would you, give me that. You need to make better choices. How old's your baby? Oh, well, he's buying diapers for somebody. Of course, then there was the time where I got cut down. This happened the other day. Do you speak another language? You speak another language? A little bit? Anybody speak another language?
Yeah.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, a little Spanish. You think with another part of your brain. It's just an amazing. I wish I did. I used to be I really had a good ear for people with a very thick accent. You know, I had friends that had and I was able to understand what they were saying. And all of a sudden, that's gone. There's a gentleman who checks, is a checker at the Safeway. And he's East Indian, which means he speaks King's English, okay? But for some reason, I have a hell of a time. He's checking out the other day. I said, oh, wait, I think I get a discount on that. And he goes, oh, this is what I heard. He goes, oh, are you retarded? Excuse me? Are you retarded? Well, there's never been testing. Retired! Oh, shit! much time I'm supposed to do. I've already been paid. I don't see Bree.
Oh, she's here. Yeah, you got 5 minutes if you want. Yeah.
Oh, hi, baby girl. There she is. She's closing the show. Yeah, that's right. She was coming from Helium because she's a working comic. She is. She's a working comic. She's actually working tonight. So it's okay. You can talk to him. Go ahead. She has a question for you. You have babies? You have babies? No babies?
Yeah.
You have baby doggies? Huh? You have pets? Of course. You live in the Pearl? Anyway. That's really the trick up there. You don't. There's no strollers in the fucking Pearl anymore. It's all dogs and shit all over the place. I love animals. I do love animals. I do. I do. Kids and dogs love me. They do. Men, not so much. I was at a baby's birthday party a couple weeks ago. Have you been to a child's birthday party in the last year or so? Is it out of control a little bit? Did you think so too? Because I'm just out of... I mean, I went to a three-year-old's birthday party, you guys. 3 years old. There were 65 people. 60. You know, when I was 3 years old, you got to have this many people because you were this many. And your mother made the cake. She drank a bottle of wine. She made the cake. There was always a little lopsided on one side, so that meant more frosting. You know, not all alcoholic memories are bad. You know. She had it catered. It was catered, this thing, this monstrosity. She had it catered. I kept wandering around going, where's the wine? She goes, well, that wouldn't be morally right if we had wine. I said, well, this whole fucking thing isn't morally right. Are you crazy? Are you crazy? This kid can count now. You know? And then, well, she didn't have anything. She didn't have really, she rented one of those jumpy jumps. You know, the jumpy jumps the kids have. It was the half the street. It was just, you know, split level, six bedrooms, you know, a terrace. It was huge because she had 25 little kids out there that she didn't want to deal with. So sticks them outside. They got heaters and stuff, and she's outside with... I'm thinking, I didn't want to stay inside with these adults. I have never lactated on purpose. So, okay, the moose didn't get that last night. I'm so happy that you did. Anyway. So, I go out, and you know, the kids, there is just a face that will lift you right into another stratosphere. When you engage with a child, and they know that you are right there with them at all times and you are going to play with them, they just give you that. I said, everybody stop jumping. Stop jumping. Be quiet like a bunny. Because when I jump, you're going to see Jesus. So, I have a couple more minutes. I just want to tell them. You're going to give me the light now?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, thanks. No, that's good. I need that. I'm just going to tell them a little bit of story.
Perfect.
A little story. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Bree, do you have another show you have to be at? I love to tell this story, and I asked her not to call me a legend because I'm certainly no legend. I am a working comic, and I've been working in stand-up comedy since 1983. Mark's been around for a long time, but I am one of Portland's original stand-up comics, and that's what I'm the most proud of. We started at a little place called the Leaky Roof Tavern on Southwest Jefferson Street, and it's still there. They have great food, but back in the day, if you put 20 people in that place, 10 of them were standing, and it did leak right over the stage, so you had an incentive to get the hell off. So, and there was lines around the block for open mics. And we were the rock and roll of the 80s. That was what stand-up comedy was. It's an American art form. Everybody in the world tries to emulate it. I'm not at the art form level, but I am striving to be. It's such a wonderful, and now it's being reinvented by these young kids and technology and everything is that it's just great. But I did live in Southern California for 13 and a half years. I drove down. my Super Beetle, my 73 Super Beetle. That's right, baby. Hitler had a dream, and I'm driving it. Anyway. And I lived down there for... Thank you, that's my favorite fucking joke. I just love that joke. Jerry Seinfeld actually wanted to buy that joke off of me, and I wouldn't give it to him. Because he's a big Volkswagen person. Anyway, you can't have it. That's mine. I came back to the Pacific Northwest for one reason. I knew I could still work as a stand-up comic, but I'm my parents' caretaker also. They're very old, and they're in the car. Told them we were getting ice cream. I hope in your lifetime, and in the many incarnations that you will have in your lifetime, and the different many different persons you will become and meld into, that I hope you have a chance to spend a lot of time with very old people, because it changes your whole perspective on just what's really important, you know, and you really learn how to make cream of wheat. I'm killer at cream of wheat. And my mother is 95. She's about this tall now, so I have that to look forward to. And she's of the greatest generation. And when we lose them, you know, everybody's going to be willy-nilly. This woman doesn't go out of the house unless her handbag and her shoes match. She's coiffed, she's done, and she's there. You know, my folks, they're there. They're there every fucking day. They're there. They just get up. What are we doing today? We're going to Costco. They're having a twofer on coffins. Let's measure. I got to cut this really short, but I just wanted to tell you, it's funny because no matter how old your mother is, and even in what position you are, because I have to pick and choose when I'm going to be a caretaker and when I'm going to be a daughter, you know. Giving your new medication, you have to take this pill. No. Mother, no. You're trying to kill me. If I wasn't going to kill you, I wouldn't use stool softener. But I got to tell her the other day, I save little tidbits, so you know, when I know she's getting a little depressed or something, I tell her something. I lie a lot, but you have to, just to keep them, their spirits up. I told her this actually isn't a lie. I got to tell her that I got hit on the other night. Now, it always happens, and every woman in this room knows exactly what I'm saying. You can look at your absolute worst. You can be sweaty at the gym, mascara under your eyes, whatever it is, and all of a sudden you're getting hit on. Now, my whole life has just been, this is crazy. Everything has fallen. Nothing stands up on its own anymore. You know, I've got the support hose, you know, all this other shit. I've got the gray hair. All of a sudden, I'm getting hit on now. Well, I work a lot of casinos. I should probably play this. And those boys love me. Come here. And I love men. And I love men. I think you're darling and cute when you're young. And we love you because you're ambitious and cute and funny. You know, if it was all about conversation, we would have died out as a species. But when you're young, but because you just takes you a few years to catch up with our really needy persons. But as you get older, you get so much better. I've never heard lines like this in my whole life. This guy comes over with a walker. He puts his arm around me and goes, "I want to tell you something." Okay. "I want to tell you something." Okay. "I'm going to tell you something. You are a beautiful woman." "Wow. Well, thank you. I'd like to take you to dinner." "Okay. Where should we go?" "Well, can you drive at night?" The best one was, Xana Chinook wins. And I sensed him. I knew something. Someone was looking at me. I don't know what it was. That radar doesn't go away. And I turned around, and there he was. He's like 6'2", in his late 70s, gorgeous silver hair, beautiful suit, beautiful. And he's smiling at me, and he goes, come here. Okay. I walked over there, and he put his arm around me. Well, he got a little side action, you know what I'm saying? He goes, you know, you and I need to be doing some crazy things together.
Whoa!
Wow. Okay, like what? Well, can you hook up an air tank? I'm your girl. You've had a wonderful time.
Amazing. You guys keep an eye out for the Harvey's calendar because she is headlining there a lot and it's always a treat. She's incredible.